The journey to the NBA is different for every player. Some have to prove themselves overseas. Some are top-ranked players at every level of the game, and others are unknowns coming out of high school. In this video, we're going to look at the high school careers of some of the top rookie names. So if you guys like my content, make sure you subscribe. And if Aaron Gordon got robbed in the dunk contest, hit the like button and let's hop into it. Now for this video, I'm not going to waste your time talking about players that you are well aware were top ranked in high school, such as Zion and RJ Barrett. Instead, I want to look at some more unique journeys. One of the biggest surprises this season is rookie Kendrick Nunn. He was practically an unknown before this year, and so far, he's averaging 15 points a game, shooting 44% from the field and 34% from three. At one point, it looked like he was the favorite to win Rookie of the Year, averaging 22 points, shooting 52% from the field and 48% from three at the start of the season. But before Kendrick Nunn would be an NBA surprise, he actually had a pretty impressive high school career. He attended Simeon High School along with future second overall pick in the draft, Jabari Parker. Together, they would win four consecutive Illinois State titles. While Jabari got most of the attention, Nunn was his partner in crime. He was just 6'2", but his lightning quick speed and ability to play above the rim led to him being ranked as the 61st player in the country and number two player in the state behind Parker. He then decided to go to the University of Illinois after having offers from the likes of Ohio State, Marquette, and Memphis. As a junior, he would average an efficient 15 points a game, but following the season, was dismissed from the team after pleading guilty to a battery charge. He then went to the University of Oakland, where he would take over, averaging 26 points, 4 assists, and 5 rebounds, and led the NCAA in 3-point production. Despite this, he went undrafted and spent this past season as a member of the Santa Cruz Warriors in the G League. He played well enough there for the Heat to sign him in April of 2019, and well, the rest is history. Next, we're going to talk about one of the fan favorites, Tyler Hero. Hero has quickly proven himself as one of the most promising young players and is already one of the top shooters in the NBA. So far this season, he's averaging 13 points, shooting 39% from three. Before all the NBA success, Hero was born in Greenville, Wisconsin, where he would attend Whitnall High School. As a 6'3 freshman, he would make a name for himself pretty quickly, averaging 16 points a game, and by the time he was a junior, that was 24 points, and he was now 6'5". Around this time, he committed to the University of Wisconsin, but as the recruiting started to heat up, he would switch his commitment to the University of Kentucky. Hero wasn't gifted with freakish athleticism, but it was his work ethic that got him to where he is today. Reportedly, he would start training at 5 a.m. in high school, and when his coach told him that he would open the school gym for him at 6 a.m., he declined because that was too late. In his final year at Whitnall, he'd become one of the biggest names in high school basketball. He averaged 33 points, 7 rebounds, and 4 assists a game, but it was his insane highlight reels that garnered him such a big following. His mixes were must-see. He was a man amongst boys. What made his highlights so exciting was it wasn't the usual poster dunks we see all the time in these videos. While he had some of those, it was his handle and ability to score off the dribble that had little kids on Instagram praising him as the next NBA great. By the end of the season, he was a 30th ranked player in his class, but going to Kentucky, he really wasn't looked at as a one-and-done prospect, unlike most of Kentucky's recruits, but after a very solid freshman season, he was selected with the 13th pick in the 2019 draft by the Miami Heat. Next, we're going to talk about the current frontrunner for Rookie of the Year and the second overall pick in the draft, Ja Morant. We now know he's one of the top young players in the league, but it wasn't an easy path to the NBA. Born in Sumter, South Carolina, he began his high school career at Crestwood High School at just 5'9". By the time he was a junior, he was just 6 foot with no major college offers. As a senior, he would average 27 points, 8 rebounds, and 8 assists a game. He would sprout up to 6'3", and for most of the season, the only major offer he had was from his home state school, South Carolina. He was unranked, and I mean unranked. He wasn't ranked in the country, his position, or even the state. Looking back at his high school footage, that seems kind of ridiculous. While his games evolved greatly, even at that time, the craftiness, athleticism, and passing was very evident. His inability to get at the least ranked in his state was most likely due to a lack of exposure. It really looked like he was destined to attend South Carolina, but was actually discovered by his future coach at Murray State by accident. attending a camp to see a player who was joining the team while looking for a snack. The coach noticed Morant playing pickup basketball, and well, you know the rest. He had a pretty solid freshman season, but was still a complete unknown going into his sophomore year, where he would shoot up the board, averaging 25 points, 10 assists, and 5 rebounds on amazing efficiency, and then boom, he's a multimillionaire. Kevin Porter Jr. has been one of the better rookies so far this season, despite being taken with the last pick in the first round. He got off to a pretty slow start, but is really starting to get things going. Since the new year, he's averaged over 14 points a game, shooting 51% from the field and 45% from three. In high school, Kevin Porter was electrifying. Born in Seattle, Washington, he attended Rainier Beach High School where, knee socks and all, he would average 27 points, 14 rebounds, and 5 assists a game as a 6'5 senior. During high school, he showed some of the most promise in my opinion. I was very high on him going into USC, and again, as you might remember if you've been following the channel, was very high on him going into the draft. His ability to rise above the rim, paired with a smooth left-handed shooting stroke, got me pretty excited about his future. He has some of the best high school mixes I have ever seen, and one of the craziest highlights in high school basketball history when he left a defender in the dust, going behind the back, and then absolutely embarrassed another defender who decided to meet him at the rim. That was insane. Next, we're going to talk about one of the most well-known rookies, despite actually going undrafted in the recent draft, Tacko Fall. Tacko was born in Dakar, Senegal, and actually had no interest in basketball for most of his life. He grew up playing soccer and didn't play organized basketball till he came to the United States at the age of 16. Once coming to the United States, due to his massive 7'5" size, basketball became more involved in his everyday life, and he actually had the opportunity to train with NBA legend Hakeem Olajuwon. He first attended Jamie's House Charter School when he came to the States, but then transferred to Liberty Christian Prep. Not only did he excel in the basketball court, averaging 19 points, 10 rebounds, and 6 blocks a game, he took school very seriously, having a 4.0 GPA. In high school, Tacko Fall was a complete glitch. Most of the time, the guy he was matched up with was maybe 6'5". Now, his size held him back in certain aspects, but he still graduated as the 16th ranked center and 10th ranked player in the state of Florida. He committed to the University of Central Florida, where he had a solid 4 years, averaging 10 points and 8 rebounds a game. He then went undrafted in the 2019 draft, but is currently on a two-way deal with the Boston Celtics. Next, we've got another surprising rookie and second-round pick, Eric Pascal. This season, as a part of the Golden State Warriors, he's averaged 13 points and 5 rebounds a game, but he's another guy that had an uphill journey to the NBA. After reportedly first dunking at the age of 12, he played most of his high school career at Dobbs Ferry in New York, where as a junior, he averaged 26 points and 11 rebounds. He then went to St. Thomas More for his senior season, where he played a big role in them making it to the National Prep School Championship title game. Being undersized for the power forward spot at 6'6", he didn't get much recruiting attention, being ranked as the 65th player at his position, but signed on to play at Fordham University. As a freshman, he averaged 16 points and 6 rebounds, and jumped on the opportunity to transfer to a bigger program in Villanova. By the time he was a 5th-year senior, he was averaging 17 points and 6 rebounds, shooting 35% from 3 on almost 6 attempts a game. This was enough for him to get drafted in the second round of the recent draft, and it now looks like he's in for a pretty long career. Lastly, we're going to talk about Cam Reddish. Now, I said I wasn't really going to talk about top recruits, but Cam is going to be the exception due to the fact of where he is now. After disappointing at Duke, he fell down the board and was drafted with the 10th overall pick by the Atlanta Hawks. So far this season, he's averaged 9 points, shooting just 35% from the field and 32% from 3. Now with that said, I don't want to completely trash on Cam. I still believe in his long-term potential. 6'9", over a 7-foot wingspan with skills like a guard. He was unguardable at the high school level. He had some of the best highlights, and at the time, there was no reason to believe he wouldn't be a future NBA superstar. As a senior, he averaged 23 points and 6 rebounds a game. He was named a McDonald's All-American and finished as the 3rd-ranked player in the country. But that's the end of the video, guys. There's plenty of more names I could have talked about. These were the ones I just felt like talking about today. You've got Jackson Hayes, Jared Culver, Darius Garland, a lot more. So if you guys want to see a part 2, tell me in the comments below. But if you liked the video, hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and the shoutouts are gonna be John Stanley, Paul, Charles, and Tomato. If you guys want to shout out on the next video, all you gotta do is like the video and comment liked or rep notification squad, and I'll shout five of you guys out. With all that being said, hope you guys have a great day, and peace.